Yo, this is man Ace Deuce. You tuned into the OG Series Vlog, where we speak real truth, we discuss real topics, which leads to real talk. Y'all tune in for our special guest, OG Mike Banks in the building, Platinum Plus producer.
What up?
Tell us, Mike, how'd you get your start?
Man, started out as the neighborhood DJ. Didn't know it was coming, but my next door neighbor happened to be messing around with some turntables one day. I was like, man, hold up. So you put hard times with rock box and then back dog that and put B-box by Art Noise with it? How did you do that? They two different speeds.
Right.
I said, man, I tuned my pitch right there. I said, pitch? We ain't got that type of equipment at the house. We got a little tape recorder. So I got to get me up on some turntable.
Yeah.
So it was a battle right there just with getting the equipment.
Right.
My mom blessed me, man.
Hey, yeah, boy. Thank God for mama.
Yeah, boy. Yeah.
Shout out, mama.
Oh, man.
Mama.
Gang, two turntables.
I'm talking about
without it. A microphone.
Two turntables.
Without a microphone.
Yeah, buddy. Hey, yeah. Once you did that, man. Yes, sir.
And then, from there.
From now?
What was the first DJ gig that you got? Like, okay, then you got your stuff.
Got my
old
stuff.
Lady hooked you up.
Like, oh,
now,
man,
what's the first gig?
The first gig.
Yeah.
But the for real gig, it like meant something.
Yeah.
It was like doing some of Cashmere's.
Right on.
Parties.
Shout out to Cashmere.
Right, right. And then I had a partner of mine named Mark Sonye, man.
Sonye, man.
Yeah, but Sonye was working with Doug King.
He might have been King.
Doug King.
So I'm sitting there. No, hold on, let me back up.
Yeah.
He was working with Bernie and Shatero.
Okay. But they you produced your first beat. Like, they, when did you think you produced your first beat?
It had to be with, Mark. Mark, we worked on a song. We took a sample.
Yeah.
And we structured it. Bernie and them helped out with the structure, the arrangements
of it.
Didn't really know how to use the equipment.
Right, right. But Mark, you can say is where you got your start with your man Mark on producing.
Peace out, Mark Sonye.
Already. Putting the drums on the track.
Yeah, yeah. So from there, man, hey, DJing a lot, man, and I was the neighborhood DJ out of Trinity, Lord. The boys D, Darrell Williams, we all went to Key.
Already. Because that was going to be the next thing. It was like, hey man, how'd you meet D from Trinity Guard Cartel? Because that's where you got all your meat,
man,
in the middle of the sandwich from.
D, okay, so we all went to Key, right? D and JF, James Foster.
Yeah, Foster.
They running the hallway. They outside. Wow. They ain't trying to go to school, but man, hey, they was skipping class. I was in class. But guess what, man? Two boats. We met together, man.
Right.
We made a connection.
Right.
They knew I was the neighborhood DJ, man.
Right.
They came to me one morning, man, and say, man, look, we know you the neighborhood DJ. We've been ducking on your goal in the backyard, but now, hey, it's time to make some money right now, man.
Yeah.
If you can make these beats, they put an easy tape in my hand and said, hey, if you can do this, we're going to pick you up in the morning. And we're going to go to the keyboard and drum shop, and we're going to get everything for the box.
When you got in the game, like once you met GM, what's some of the biggest names that you kind of worked with back in the day?
Well, man, okay, so the beginning of Trinity Guard Quartet, that was my first group that we actually like did this
family
project.
Right.
Going from song, we got so many songs that's unheard that actually didn't make the first cut.
Right.
That's when, you know, I met with, you worked with Big Richard.
I
believe that had Destiny's Child. So, man, the piece up is just fresh, man.
These people showed me about how
everything supposed to work in the studio, how you supposed to separate everything.
Yeah.
Right.
Even though I didn't know the equipment, they just, man,
which really now you focusing in on engineering,
yeah,
which some people can produce and can't quite engineer.
Yeah.
They don't really know that you can also engineer as well as mix,
master, career, as well as
man, it's really, really deep. It's really deep. So you work with Trinity Guard Cartel.
Yeah, Trinity Guard Cartel. That was the
bread and butter.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like that was my training.
Yeah.
Cause each day was like training field.
Yeah.
I felt that every day I got a chance the way D-Nim worked at the field and was, you know, still is today.
Yeah, real tough.
You could be replaced. You know what I'm saying? So it's kind of like, Mike B, what's up? But understand that,
you gotta make the cut.
We need the song done by today. What's going on?
So not to switch it up, but just to laugh a minute. I remember the first time we walked into that studio, man. And man, it was tight. Like when we walked in there, man, it was like, it was tight. Them niggas looking at us, we looking at them, we like, hey man.
We had to see go back to the question that he just asked you, the group that you worked with after the TGC. We was them dudes, some of the first guys too, right after them, that you worked with.
Yeah, actually, you guys were outside of, I don't know what came first, Big Mike or you.
Yeah.
But y'all kind of at the same time.
Right.
Y'all were like the first.
For us, Big Mike, Rap-A-Lot, James, you know, started to take interest hearing the beats.
Man,
so you guys were like the first person that actually like for real, okay, it's serious.
Yeah.
It's serious as for a contract situation. We need to be agreement
These tracks
Trinity Garden was my start group, meaning like we still learning the game.
Yeah.
Can't nobody tell us no, we finna do it.
Independent.
No, we finna do whatever we need to do. Money is no object. We finna do it.
Right.
Let's be concerned on where we're gonna go. We're gonna make a certain amount of dance cuts, a certain amount of street cuts.
Right.
We know we got our obstacle is radio, our obstacle is travel and promotion, so we gonna get it.
So,
D-Nim was that. Man, when I call like a boxer, train in the gym every day, you need to spar every day, you need to get up on your exercise every day.
Oh, man. Like he said, to go back to the story,
it was super tight. Like it was tight.
D-Nim was looking it up, but at the same time,
we came in now, it was like, hey,
we need to be
Mike. It was like,
Coco. Coco is the one that hooks
up. I just ran into Coco, man.
Coco's the one hooked us up.
Yeah,
shout out to Coco, man.
Really, like a lot of times, D-Nim would tell me, because they were older than me, so they could kind of pinpoint a person's vibe.
Trying to
mess over me.
Right
not,
on.
You know,
right.
I'm feeling them, but guess what? You need to make sure you say this to them. It's mentorship.
Oh, yeah, no doubt.
Shout out to the TGC, man. Trinity Guard Cartel, man. Strong movement. Y'all saw some music, too.
Yeah.
You got soul, man.
We rap a lot, man. David, rap a lot, really. That was another level of training.
Because now you're venturing out. Yeah. Now after the H Deuce, you going into the lot and rap a lot with B.
Men's Clan,
you work with Joe. Joe was definitely a great mentor.
I worked with Coles on the project with Joe, he came through, listened to some of my stuff, man. He enhanced some stuff, man.
Right.
And I was like, cool.
Master of the game. Shout out to Joe, man. Say, they don't know.
Mike Dean.
Say, man.
Would do things in the mixdown that he didn't even have to do. Because a lot of engineers, especially if I don't know your facility and you're the core engineer of that place, and my position is to, oversee the mix, you don't have to really EQ a drum how it needs to be done. You know, of course, at that time, I couldn't run an SSL board, whatever, but he knew. You know, he knew what needed to be done.
Shout out to
him. I mean, man, they be working on De La Soul stuff, man. I be just like, man. Before I want to get on that project
And then speaking of that, what you had for
him? I was asking Mike. Well, also we forgot to touch on Mike. Mike also with something serious.
That was your first.
But so, what your biggest project till?
Biggest project
from one all the way. From the first biggest to that one where you just went.
I say Big Mike first.
Which is what we have in the background.
That's the one I have a gold pack for. Another gold with E-40, Cop Trump Change. Don't have a plaque for that.
But what record, what album do you remember the album that was on?
It's called Trump Change.
Trump Change.
That was the album?
I think so.
Trump Song.
I know it's the name of the song.
Okay.
But got that through working with a man named Big Time. Randy. Yeah, Randy Jefferson.
Yeah, I remember Randy.
Me and Green helped that situation out. But that one and another jam that I worked on with Randy Jefferson.
This is on E-40 as well, or Master P.
Yeah,
so we got Big Mike, we got E-40, got Master P.
Stop Hating. Oh, was the name of that song?
Yeah.
Then, what else? For Major Placement, Mr. Mike, when he was on Priority.
Right.
You guys.
Right, when he was on Priority.
Yeah.
You produced the meat of that work.
And so now, lately, I think 2005, Mike Jones.
Okay.
Featuring B. Mike. Rest in Peace. I did Flossing.
Big Mo.
That song was Double Platinum.
Right on. Double Platinum, man?
Yeah.
Double Platinum.
Yeah. The OGV law is where we speak real truth.
We discuss real talk.
We speak real talk.